Hello everyone, and thanks for tuning back in. Alessandro the Crypto here. I hope you're doing all fine. Let's start trading a 1 hour time frame for in the Bitcoin price, because everything is plunging today, guys. We have the stock market completely crashing. We have this play out now of this rising wedge that we have seen in the last couple of days and weeks, and also Bitcoin currently is following. So yesterday I told you that we were in this potential rising wedge, which is a bearish pattern. We had the breakout to the downside, and currently we are reaching the target here of $8,500 approximately, but I still think that we could even go down to $8,000, and this is where I have my first long set in case that we are gonna bounce here at these levels. So I'm still thinking that till the halving, there is a high chance that we could still reach this $10,500. But currently it looks like that we are taking another correction here, possibly down to the 200 daily moving average and also to the previous resistance, which now should be acting as a support. So in the smaller time frames, of course, we are very oversold now after this play out of this rising wedge. We are oversold in the RSI and stochastic in the 1 hour. Bollinger Band is also trading in the lower area, and we are right at the bottom. MACD had a bearish cross, and as you can see, it looks like that we could form here in the next couple of hours a bullish cross. But as I told you, I still think that we could reach here even the $8,000 level before we see any kind of bounce to the upside again. Also in the 4 hour, you see that we are now trading below the 20 moving average in the 4 hour. This moving average is not anymore as a support, but now new resistance in case that we still continue to trade to the downside. Stochastic is already oversold, and the RSI just starting to trade below the 50. So here also we have a lot of room left to the downside, and here this 50 moving average in the 4 hour at 8,420. I think there we could see a little breather to the upside, possibly to test again the 20 moving average and then possibly go down towards the $8,000. I still think 8,000 is very likely to reach. Let's see if it's also holding as a support. In the Bollinger Band here, we are still shifted to the downside. Here also the momentum looks clearly shifted to the downside, and we are in this tiny channel here in the Bollinger Band in the 4 hours, so we could easily overshooting it to the downside here if we're gonna reach this 8K target. And also here in the daily, you see that we were overbought here in the RSI and stochastic, so this correction was expectable here. We were overbought in the daily. We can't go down to test the 220 daily moving average and see a bounce there easily and then reach this $10,500 target. So this is what I think could happen just before the halving. What's going to happen after reaching 10K or after the halving, this is what we're going to see. But till the halving, so 7 days left, I think we could see here a big bounce from this 200 daily and or 20 daily moving average. And also if we can cool down here the RSI back to the 50 level and bounce from it, this would give us even more fire to the upside. And if we have a look on the Bollinger Band in the daily, you can see that also here we were trading right at the top. So a retracement back down at least towards the middle here at around 7,730 is very likely. Here the MACD is still shifted to the upside, so we're gonna have to see in case that here we're gonna have a bearish cross, then this could indicate that we maybe not gonna bounce here from the 50 level here, so around 8,000, but maybe even go lower towards again $6,000. This would be really the worst case scenario, but it's not out of the cards. The only bullish thing here is that in the weekly, we are starting to trade above the 50 in the RSI. Stochastic is still shifted to the upside, and we're still trading above the 20 weekly moving average. So it's also depending how we're gonna close this week. Of course, we could see a possible retest of the 20 weekly down here at around $7,900 and then bounce again to the upside towards $10,000 if we're gonna see that bounce. But in theory here on the weekly, everything looks still bullish. And even here watching at the Bollinger Band, you see that we could easily go down to test again the middle area, have it as a confirmation, a support at $8,000 and then bounce to the upside towards this $10,500. And don't forget, we had a bullish cross here in the MACD in the weekly. So in the bigger time frames, we are still more bullish than bearish. So in the short time frames, it looks like that we're going to continue to plunge maybe in the next couple of days, at least till $8,000. But for the long term, it's still looking very, very bullish. So as I tell you every time, guys, be ready for all scenarios. If you don't have anything fiat on the sideline, take now some profits out and buy back in once we're seeing a bigger correction, because it is possible that we're gonna continue to plunge in the next couple of days. The stock market is doing very bad today. Of course, also there, we're gonna probably bounce somewhere. But if this rising wedge is gonna completely play out here, prepare to see again the lows that we had a couple of weeks ago. So with that said, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up. If you like the content, you know what to do. Make also sure to subscribe to the channel, because I do daily TA videos, and also you can participate to my $10 Bitcoin giveaway that I do with every 100 subscribers. And also, if you want to take advantage of these swings when we go up and down, and you want to take as much profits as you can trade over on Bybit, Femex, Bityard, Prime XBT. On all these four exchanges, you can trade up to 100x. And with my sign up links, you can get some free sign up bonus. So go and check them out and get these free rewards that they are giving to you, so you can start to trade without taking any risk. And don't forget, join our free Discord trading chat. It's completely for free and everyone is welcome. And you can also follow me over on Twitch. There I'm gonna do the live streams sometimes. So thank you very much for watching, guys, and we see us all in the next one. Bye.